A dangerous new synthetic drug called Flakka is taking hold in parts of the U.S., and authorities say it's mostly coming into the country in the mail from China.
Now, Flakka, which is also called gravel, sells for just a few dollars per dose on the streets. That's how it got its nickname, $5 insanity. Insanity because it often causes hallucinations, aggression, and paranoia. Its effects on the brain last longer, and it can be more. It can do more damage than cocaine. U.S. Drug Enforcement Special Agent Kevin Stanfill has been trying to fight the surge in Flakka use in the state of Florida. He is joining us now from Miami. I've just been reading about the effects of Flakka, what it does to people, and these stories are just wild. Can you just give us a sense of what this drug does to people when they take it?
Well, what they call is, they call it excited delirium. If you recall back in the 70s and 80s, PCP, LSD, when people, some people would take these drugs, they would have like superhuman strength. Here in South Florida, we have instances where people have taken Flakka and it's taken six police officers to hold them down. Of course, this presents a lot of problems for law enforcement, a lot of problems for the community, and also the person taking Flakka.
From what I understand, at least in one county in Florida, in Broward County, 3 to 4 hospitalizations a day on average because of Flakka. Explain this rise of, in popularity of this drug in the state of Florida. Why is this happening?
Well, the thing that that alarms us about Flakka is it's very cheap. It's, you could get a dosage unit of Flakka cheaper than you can get a Big Mac. I have a 16-year-old son. He's always has $5 in his pocket. You can get Flakka for $5 to $3. I mean, it's very inexpensive. It's been marketed toward both people with don't have a lot of money, homeless people, recovering drug addicts, but also our children. So it's cheap. It's readily available, and so that's why we're very alarmed over it.
Let's talk about the supply end of this, which I find quite interesting. U.S. drug officials blaming Chinese suppliers for the proliferation of Flakka in the U.S., particularly in the state of Florida. Are U.S. drug officials working with Chinese officials to stop the supply side of this?
Well, we do have an office in China. The problem that we have is the primary drug used for Flakka is alpha PVP. It's not against the law to make it or sell it in China at this time. We had emergency schedule. It's a Schedule 1 controlled substance, March of 2014. Now it's illegal. The problem that we have is you have chemists in China. Every time that we come up with a schedule so that we can make it illegal, they will change some of the compounds in this drug so it's not exactly what it was when we first identified it. So we have to start all over again. So that makes it extremely difficult for us.
I mean, what's the appeal of this drug? Who are the kinds of people that are using this Flakka? Is it young teenagers, adults, or does it really cover everyone?
At this time, it's mainly with, you're going to see teenagers, you're going to see both young adults, people, homeless people, people that don't have a lot of money. It's not a drug that you're going to, people that are going to spend $100 or $200 on. This is something that anybody can afford, and that's the market that they're going after. If you've got $5 in your pocket, you're a potential Flakka customer.
And how is Flakka different from bath salts, which is also a man-made drug?
Well, it was a good question. Back in 2012, that's when we first came across Flakka. It was used the same as bath salts, the K2 and the spice. People were that was coming over from China, and they were selling that as the bath salts. It came back now, 2014, it arrives on the scene again with a new name, Flakka, a little bit sexier than bath salts, and at a much cheaper price. But it's in the same chemical, it's one of the same drugs as the bath salts, K2 spice.
So very, very similar, and I can tell you, you know, Miami is my old stomping grounds, and the last story that I covered as a reporter in Miami was a man on bath salts eating the face off of a homeless man. So when you hear these stories about these drugs gaining popularity, it is absolutely concerning. Kevin Stanfill, DEA Special Agent, really great having you on the program. Thanks so much.